Ayubuan, Mr. Chairman of the panel, Honorable Minister of Healthcare and Nutrition for Sri Lanka, and the current Chairman of the Executive Board of the WHO, Mr. Honorable Nimachal Pala De Silva, distinguished members of the panel, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Honorable Minister of Healthcare and Nutrition of Sri Lanka, Honorable Nimachal Pala De Silva, let me bring you greetings from Sri Lanka. At the outset, let me thank the organizers of this conference for the invitation extended to us to share with the world community the Sri Lankan experience, a success story with regard to dealing with a common but serious problem we, the developing and underdeveloped countries, share, which is the under 5 malnutrition problem. Sri Lanka is an island nation situated south of India and is historically known as the Pearl of the Indian Ocean and also as the Paradise Island for its immense natural and scenic beauty with its natural golden beaches and the evergreen lush vegetation. These and its tropical climate makes it a much sought after tourist destination in the world. The cool high mountains in its central region produces the world-famous Ceylon tea, most of you are familiar with. Having a population of 19 million, it has a land mass of 62,705 square kilometers. Sri Lanka has a parliamentary democracy with an executive president as its head of state. Health services of the country function under a dedicated ministry, which is a senior cabinet portfolio. For 300 years, Sri Lanka was under foreign domination, under the Portuguese, the Dutch, and finally under the British, up to the year 1948, when it got its independence. Comparing the vital statistics now with the pre-independence era, 1945, one can see the tremendous improvement Sri Lanka has seen with impressive achievements to its credits with regard to the health indicators over the last 60 odd years. Maternal mortality rate from a high 165 per 10,000 live births have come down drastically to a mere 5.9. Infant mortality rate has dropped down from 140 per 1,000 live births to a very low 11.2. Life expectancy as a result of overall health achievements has risen up to a formidable 73 years, bringing Sri Lanka in par with the developed countries. So are the achievements in literacy rates as shown in this slide. The known contributory factors to these successes have mainly been the commitment of the successive governments to keep health and education high in its national agenda. The present Minister of Health for Sri Lanka, Honorable Nimal Sripala De Silva, who is here with us on the panel today, is the longest serving health minister, completing 10 years as Minister of Health, and incidentally is also the longest serving health minister in the region. He has been able to convince the government to bring health to the helm of national budget, only being second to defense and education. The health budget under his reigns has grown threefold during the last decade, bringing it to 3% of GNP, which can be considered as a great success for a developing country. With this and the clear vision he has been able to do a lot of improvement in the health sector during the past decade. Today, Sri Lanka stands proud ahead of all the regional countries and has come in par with the developed countries in health sector achievements. The government policy is to provide health and education absolutely free to its people, considering it as an investment to produce a healthy, literate workforce to support its economy. The well-established health infrastructure and a dedicated workforce has made health services easily accessible to the people. At a glance, you can see the obvious steady downward trend in stunting and undernutrition over the last 3 decades in this slide. And stunting has dropped from a high 49.9% to 18% in 2006. Undernutrition has dropped from 57.3% to 22. However, wasting has remained static, but in a low profile, with a little or no improvement or change over the years. These figures are quite impressive and encouraging for a developing country and can be considered as a success, which have been achieved against the odds of a terrorist war affecting the country's economy over the last 3 decades. It has been found that the contributory factors for these progress have been comprehensive maternal and child care package delivered by the health ministry over the years, namely a comprehensive antenatal care service to the mothers, which is effectively delivered through well-established public health network in the country. In Sri Lanka, every 600 families are looked after by a trained public health midwife at grassroots levels, delivering the primary health care. This dedicated field health staff ensure promotion of exclusive breastfeeding, which stands now at 57%, with a predominant breastfeeding figure of 87%. They also encourage and supervise complementary feeding at appropriate times. They do personally supervise the delivery of mega dose of vitamin A to the children. They also regularly follow up on the growth monitoring of the children under their care. The health workers are also trained to do surveillance for malnutrition. Health promotion is also considered important in empowering the vulnerable groups to overcome malnutrition. A well-established supplementary feeding program at national level has helped the government to overcome and fill the gaps in the system. Under the present government, the subject of nutrition has been given the highest priority, having realized the importance of nutrition as a vehicle for economic development. The government has renamed the Ministry of Health as Ministry of Healthcare and Nutrition. This itself emphasizes and endorses the political commitment Sri Lanka has towards improving the nutritional status of its people. The head of state of Sri Lanka, His Excellency the President Mahinda Rajapaksa, has declared a dedicated supplementary feeding program for mothers, preschool children, and also for vulnerable school children. This program is spelled out very clearly in the election manifesto of His Excellency the President as the Mahinda Chintana National Program, which means the vision of His Excellency Mahinda Rajapaksa. This has already been successfully implemented. It includes a free basket of nutritional foods to all pregnant mothers, a monthly allowance of milk to all children over 2 years, a special school meal program for vulnerable school children, free food rations for all the families below the poverty line who are referred to as Samurdhi beneficiaries. Apart from these, the agriculture-based economy of the country has made food accessible to all the people of Sri Lanka. Apart from these measures, the Ministry of Health started a dedicated supplementary feeding program to combat the high prevalence of maternal and child nutrition in the past. This was called the Three Posha Program, established in 1973 in collaboration with CARE and USAID. This program was taken over full-time by the ministry in 1986 and is now run at an annual cost of US$7.5 million to the government. Three Posha literally means three nutritious foods together. It carries a balanced diet of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, minerals, and vitamins in the composition given here. It contains carbohydrates in the form of maize, proteins in the form of soybeans, fat in the form of milk, and minerals and vitamins in required amounts. These ingredients are mixed into a powder in a dedicated factory where it's packeted and distributed by the ministry through its maternal and child health clinics. Triposhi is given free of charge to children between 5 months to 5 years who are detected with moderate malnutrition or those who show growth faltering. It's also given to all pregnant mothers, all lactating women up to 6 months, and all families below the poverty line. Each beneficiary is given a take-home ration of 50 grams per day on a once-a-month basis. A beneficiary therefore gets two packets of 750 grams each, making it 1,500 grams per month for each beneficiary. Though the ideal ration per beneficiary is 100 grams per day, the limited capacity of the factory does not permit us to meet the real need of a beneficiary. There are 1.2 million beneficiaries each month who require this supplement, but only 600,000 beneficiaries receive Triposha at present due to the capacity shortage. In terms of supply and demand, therefore we cater only to 50% of the beneficiaries, and that too only 50 grams per day, half the ideal requirement. Having identified maternal and child malnutrition as a public health problem, and having realized that it goes beyond the shores of health, the health sector, the ministry, under the personal direction of the Honorable Minister, has drafted a national nutrition policy and also a national plan of action based on the policy. With a multi-sectoral approach, taking all stakeholders on board to make it a realistic and an effective program. We also have deployed a national nutrition surveillance system to strengthen the program. Through an integrated nutrition package, we intend to do a targeted supplementary feeding program addressing the vulnerable groups to make it more effective. Since the capacity of existing supplementary feeding program is not adequate, the ministry is now exploring the possibility of expanding the Triposha factory with donor assistance. Finally, the ultimate objective of the government is to implement an integrated nutrition package, taking the life cycle approach using different but appropriate interventions targeting vulnerable stages of life. On behalf of the Honorable Minister of Healthcare and Nutrition, Mr. Nimal Sirisiripala De Silva, lastly, let me thank all the UN and donor agencies and countries for the support and assistance given to the government of Sri Lanka to achieve substantial progress in combating maternal and child nutrition in Sri Lanka. We continue to look forward to your continued support in the future too. Thank you very much.